Hi, I am Ms.Forler, and I am a third grade teacher at Rhoades Elementary School. The science lesson today is called, What is a Fossil? Mr. Crosslin is going to help our class today.
Hey, thanks for inviting me to your class. I tell you, this is one of my favorite lessons of all time because I love fossils. And Indiana is rich in fossils. We have lots of fossils here. The one fossil that most kids like, though, are dinosaurs, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to talk a little bit about dinosaurs today. There are no dinosaurs in Indiana unless you go to the Children's Museum and go to Dinosphere. But for many years, I took teachers and kids out to South Dakota to dig dinosaur fossils. The dirt that used to be where dinosaurs lived has been scraped away in Indiana. We don't have dinosaur fossils, but we have fossils that are much, much, much older than dinosaurs right here. So let's get started. The first thing I want you to do is on your worksheet, on the top of it or on the back of your paper, is here's a question is, what is a fossil? And I'll tell you, that was a hard question. And I've got some ideas about this. And I want you to write this on the back of your page. A fossil is, this is a new word you probably haven't heard before, preserved evidence, of past life. Repeat after me. A fossil.
A fossil.
Is preserved.
Is preserved.
Evidence.
Evidence.
Of past life.
Of past life.
I'm going to underline some of these words that you don't maybe understand. Preserved. Evidence. Past. And life. Okay? So, let's think about those words for just a moment. So, I underline some of these words. A fossil is preserved evidence of past life. What does preserved mean? It means
saved.
So instead of an animal dying and being eaten or crumbled up or the wind blows it away or the sun bleaches it and it crumbles and it's gone, it's preserved. So it's saved. So an animal from a long time ago can die and be saved. Now what is evidence?
Clues.
So it might be the bones left over, or it could be a footprint. What if a large animal stepped in the mud and the mud dried, the sun dried it, and there was a nice imprint of a dinosaur footprint, and then along came some more mud and filled it in. That could be evidence that a dinosaur walked here, or the bone, or a leaf. Now, what does past mean?
A long time.
Yeah, and you know what? I'm not even going to tell you how long. I got in more arguments with scientists because some scientists would say it has to be a long, long time ago. And some scientists would say it would be a long, 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 long time ago. And some scientists would say a fossil has to be 10,000 years or more, or millions of years. So I'll just say that a fossil is long, long, dot, 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 time ago. Okay? So a fossil is from long, long, dot, 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 time ago. And we can argue about that later, how long ago that is. And past, long time ago, life. What is life?
Plants
or animals. So if you find a rock that's just a rock, is that a fossil?
No.
But if you find something that used to be a plant or an animal, then that's a fossil. So this is a good definition. A fossil is preserved evidence of past life. Okay, so to understand a fossil a little bit better, Mrs. Fowler, what would happen, heaven forbid, if Mrs. Fowler, your teacher, all of a sudden dropped dead out in the swamp?
Oh, no, what would happen?
What would happen?
I would cry to death.
Yeah, that would be terrible. But let's see, let's take a look at her. Would her sweater turn into a fossil?
No.
Now, what about her clothes?
No.
Now, if she just laid there, she'd probably get eaten and her bones would be scattered. But what if she got buried real quick? What parts would stay in a many long, long time? What about her hair? Would it stay?
No.
Her skin?
No.
The skin would go away. What about her muscles?
Yes.
They would stay?
No.
Yeah.
Her jaw and bones would stay.
Wait a minute. We got to hear it. You think that her bones would stay, right?
But not muscles, but her bones and her muscles.
So the muscles would go away, but the bones would stay. And so after a long time, Ms.Forler, we might find your skeleton. And look at her smile. See her teeth? Show us your teeth. Her teeth are really strong. They're covered with enamel. And so there's a good chance that your teeth would last a long time. So if she fossilized, heaven forbid, and a long, long ... time from now... we would find not her soft parts, but her bones and maybe her teeth. Thanks. Don't become a fossil yet, though, all right?
I'll try not to. Well, Mr. Crosslin, why don't you show us how a fossil forms?
I'd love to. Check this out. You guys, let's draw this picture. So, how does a fossil form? You have a drawing right there on your paper, and there's like three different sections. Now, not all fossils form exactly this way, but we're going to show you how one way a fossil can form. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so let's start, write this real small, a long, long, ... time ago. Go ahead and write that. A long, long, ... time ago, there was an ocean. See the ocean right here? Go ahead and draw that. And the bottom of that ocean was mud. Okay. And in that ocean lived a fish. I'm going to draw my fish. It's alive. It has a tail. It has gills, an eyeball. And I'm putting some bubbles like this. Why would I put bubbles going up?
Because
to show it's a... That's alive, yeah, it's alive. So, and there's my fish. Go ahead and make this drawing. Okay, so a long, long time ago, I forgot, ... that fish was living in an ocean quite different. Do you know that in Indiana, a long, long, ... time ago, we were covered with an ocean?
What?
And it was so long ago, we didn't have fish like this. We had other sea creatures. Indiana used to be an ocean quite different than the animals today. Here's what happened. This mud is still here, and for some reason, this fish died. And so this fish died, and now I'm going to put the dead fish down here in the mud. And it's going to get covered really quick. If it gets covered really quick with more mud, that's a good thing for a fossil. Okay? So the fish dies and is covered by mud. No air, no light. Go ahead and make this drawing. Okay, so this fish dies and the bottom is covered by mud. That's a good thing for a fossil because we don't want air and sun and other animals to eat it. Otherwise, there'd be nothing left. What happens if it was just laying on the bottom of the ocean? What might come along and do something? What?
Bugs
might?
A shark?
Worms. Crabs?
Worms?
Spiders?
No,
probably not spiders at the bottom of the ocean, but maybe.
Ants?
So animals would eat it. What happens if it was up by the waves on the beach?
And it'll get washed away.
It would get smashed up and parts of it would come off. Maybe birds would carry it away. What happens if it's laying out in the sun?
It would dry out.
Yeah, and then what happens if the wind comes?
It blows away.
So most things, when they die, do not turn into fossils. Most things either get eaten, busted up, dried, or blown away. Okay, so now, a long, long ... time ago, there was a fish swimming in an ocean. It was happy. It dies. It's buried in mud and preserved. So we have a long time ago, past, we have life because it's an animal, and it's preserved, saved. So now the land changes. And so these layers, here's the dead fish, but all that's left now is the bones of the fish and the outline. And this gets buried deep underground. So today, there may be fossils right under your feet that you don't know about until we dig them out. And so, let me see if I can dig these out. So here's this fossil. So I'm going to dig straight down right here like this. And all of a sudden, I'm at a layer where the fossil is, and I can find the fossil. Go ahead and make your final drawing. All right, so we made a drawing, and look at here what Chelsea did on her drawing. Okay, so I love this. You have long, time ago, there was a fish. It's dyed, and it's covered by mud, and then it's uncovered, the hard parts. This is amazing. So let me show you in real life what that looks like. Look here. It is a fish that a long time ago used to be alive, and look what it's in. Rock. This is a fossil of a fish that used to be alive a long time ago. Now how is this different than a real fish? A real fish is not
in the rock.
In the rock, right?
It's in the water.
It's in the water. A real fish still has what?
Scales.
Eyeballs, muscles, and soft parts. And a real fish is alive, right?
Yes.
Now someone found this in a rock. They cut it out and they prepared it for us so you could see it, right? And so this is just like our drawing. And this is buried deep in the ground. This one actually came from a place called Wyoming, which is known for fossils and fish. Nice. Now, I'll tell you, I brought some other fossils. It's better not to touch these because that is millions of years ago, and if I rubbed it, it'll come off. Now, I'll tell you, Indiana used to look different. This is what Indiana used to look like a long time ago. Look at these animals that are here. These animals are not alive today. In fact, there's a name for it. What do you call an animal that it used to be alive a long time
ago?
What is it?
Extinct.
Right. So this is called, you guys can say these cool words. These are from Indiana. We don't find the living ones. We find the fossils. Can you say cephalopod?
Cephalopod.
Can you say brachiopod?
Brachiopod.
And one of my favorites, trilobite.
Trilobites.
Now, here's coral. We find coral today and we find gastropods. They're like snails today, but they're different. And if you're from Indiana, one of the most famous fossils that's in all the museums of the world is this thing right here called a crinoid. So this is what Indiana used to look like a long time ago. And now these animals are extinct and we don't have an ocean like that anymore.
Is that a squid?
It's a type of a squid. There you go.
It's like a squid.
But here's another thing. Indiana dried up, and then it turned into a swamp. And look at this. This is a plant. So the fish is an animal. This is a plant. Okay, so these are plants from Indiana. And I found this rock. It was here like this. And when I got some paper on it, but I cracked it open. And this was a plant that fell in the mud millions of years ago and was preserved. And then I was able to dig it and find it. Now, that's evidence. This one is kind of weird. Before I show you that, let me show you this one. This one is a rock, but this rock is real smooth and it was found inside the ribs of a dinosaur like this. And today we know that some animals swallow rocks in their stomach to help grind their food. So here is a fossil that used to be inside the belly of a dinosaur. Is that just crazy or what?
That's crazy.
It's disgusting. Well, now what's the evidence? Because that just looks like a rock. The evidence is the scientist, the paleontologist, found this inside of fossilized rib bones. For example, here is a rib bone, part of a dinosaur. It's real.
Yes.
That is part of a dinosaur rib bone. Show me your ribs. Where are your ribs at? Right there. Yeah. So if you found a rib bone in the dirt and underneath it were a rock like this, and then the other side were more rib bones, you might have evidence that this was inside of the rib or the stomach of a dinosaur. So that's a rib bone from an Edmontosaurus that T-Rex like to eat. And a lot of these came from South Dakota. Here is, that is part of the tailbone of a dinosaur. And that's just one of the bones inside of the tail.
I know that kind of bone.
You know this kind of bone, yeah.
Yes.
It's. We have some in our back that are like this. If you've ever eaten a chicken or turkey, and look at its neck, next time you do, see if you see a bone like that. So I'm going to set that dinosaur bone right there. And one of my favorite, though, this is the toe bone of a dinosaur.
Toe?
Yeah. Now, here's the deal. It says, like, my thumb, the toenail is missing, but under my thumb is a bone. This is the bone underneath the claw of a dinosaur. Its toe. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
And this was a small dinosaur. You're right. Maybe not. Maybe the size of an elephant. An elephant, maybe.
Raptor dinosaur.
Yeah, and then finally, here's another fossil from another time. Of course, I love this one because it's a hard part. And look what that is.
A tooth.
It's a tooth.
Yeah, it's a tooth of. In fact, a tooth of. What do you think?
T-Rex.
No, I'll show you a T-Rex tooth.
It's a shark.
This is a tooth of a shark, but an ancient prehistoric shark called a, what?
Megalodon.
Well, you guys know your fossils. This is a megalodon shark tooth. I'll let you hold that in a moment, but please be careful with it because it's millions of years old. And it's a heart. Yeah, if it falls at a break. But it's a, now this shark was a bigger than a car, maybe the size of a school bus. It's
a great white shark.
I know, it would eat a great white shark for lunch.
It's like a
Jurassic World. Yeah, from the Jurassic World. Now, so these are all fossils that we've been studying, and these are the real things. I'll let you hold these and touch these in a minute. And what's in here? Well, sometimes when we find a fossil like this, we like to make a copy of it. Scientists do that. And so when I was at the Children's Museum, this is the tooth. I'll show you what we did. We made a copy of it. So this is a tooth of a T-Rex, a small tooth of a T-Rex. And it's made out of plastic. We took the real one and put it in clay. We squeezed it down in clay, and then we poured special rubber over it. And then we took it out, and we ended up making what's called a mold. And we used Legos to lock it. There's a mold. So we used the Legos to lock them in. Look, we put them in here like that. And then we pour plastic down here, which that's made out of. And so we pour that in there, we let it dry. See, and we let it dry, not too long. Takes,
you can see it,
and then,
like, from the outside.
Yeah, and when you open it up, we have a copy of the original.
And
it shows in the bottom. And I tell you, most museums, you hardly ever find the fossils that are complete, because I'm just lucky. When we dug these fossils, they would break apart at the Children's Museum when we were out there. We put glue all over them. Getting them back is only part of the work. The real work is turning them back into a dinosaur skeleton. And there might be some missing parts. So we make them out of plastic and put real ones with plastic ones. In fact, here is some claws. And that is a mold, and that's a cast, mold and a cast of two claws from dinosaurs. Now, this one is, I think that one is a Velociraptor. So we have the real fossil,
real,
and we have a cast, but a very good model of one.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna make a cast of a fossil. And so I'm going to give you some clay, okay? And this is the hard part. You're going to have to squeeze it together, and you're going to, it's going to take a lot of squeezing, okay? And then you're going to make a, see, this is like mud from a long, long time ago. Okay, and so along comes a, and I'm going to make it into a cup, like a little cup, like a biscuit. See, like that?
Yeah.
Okay, and look, there's my fingerprints, okay? They would fossilize. So I see how I did that? Yes, yes?
Yes, yes.
And so then comes a dinosaur that walks across it. Chunk, chunk. And look, what do you see right there?
Footprint.
And then, let's see, let's add something else to this. Let's see. Let's add a this is called an imprint. Let's imprint this shell, and one, two, three, and and I'll pass them these shells. Everybody can use some of these shells. One, two, three, and make a lot of imprints. I want some dinosaurs. This would be crazy. I've never done this before, but let's try this. But I did go out to South Dakota where they found a dinosaur called Leonardo. And
Leonardo!
Yeah, they named
died.
Him. Well, they named him Leonardo because when they pulled him out, look what they found in the mud.
Oh,
can you see that?
It's like his
check it out. We actually found the skin of a dinosaur out of the Black Hills Geological Institute. So I'll tell you one thing, I'm going to give you a bunch of these and make an imprint. Okay, make an imprint, but don't make it too deep. You might not get it out. There's a nice imprint. Footprints, and this would be, some scientist in the future is going to think, what in the world is this all about? We got dinosaurs, seashells, and someone's fingerprint? Okay, let's see what we do next. Okay, so the first thing that's going to happen is you guys are going to get a piece of clay, and you're going to have to really squeeze it together. It's going to be cold and hard, but the more you squeeze it, then it gets soft. Then you're going to imprint some fossils on here. And I'm going to put just a little bit, I'll come by and put a little bit of oil on there, just a little bit of oil, but you don't want to ruin your fossil. If you want it, so we're going to put something in there that doesn't stick. So I got a little bit of oil on there, and see how that looks kind of cool. Yes, yes?
Yes.
Okay, and then we're going to add, I have this chemical, it's a solid, it's called plaster of Paris. It was called plaster of Paris because there was a big deposit of this. This used to be part of the ocean, and it was found underneath the city of Paris and was used for walls. And plaster of Paris, when I mix it with water, about this much water, this is going to happen quick. So I put this much water in there, and then once I have to start stirring it, because right now we have a chemical reaction coming. Be careful. Listen and look. It turns into plaster. Hopefully you've never broken your arm, but
no.
Now look, watch, look, you need to look. You gotta get all of it, you need to get it all ready. I need a little more water, not much, just a little more, because you wanna get this nice, no bubbles, no dry parts. And you wanna get it almost like toothpaste, you know what I'm saying?
Toothpaste,
yes. All right, now look, this is almost perfect. And then, you see that?
Yes.
Okay, no lumps. And then I'm gonna take it, I'm gonna put it right here on this, and try not to let it go over.
It looks like glue.
And it, okay, I'm gonna put a little more on there. This is almost a little dry, but it looks like sour cream. You are right.
I know, right.
Yeah, it's like a piece of cake.
I know that.
Okay, and so I'm gonna push it up against my imprints, okay, and once it's done, I'm going to shake it, and look, if I kind of shake it a little bit like that, look what it does, look, see how it gets smooth on the top there?
Yeah.
Okay, and then I'm going to wait, I'm going to leave it, hopefully it will dry really quick, and then after it dries, this is like a long, long
time ago,
a dinosaur walked across some mud and then put its head in the mud for some strange reason. And then a seashell got stuck in it and blew away for some reason. And then later, some new mud came in, covered it up, and then it waited for a long, long time ago. And we'll see it turn to stone, and we'll see if we can have an imprint and a cast. Do you guys want to try this back at your seats?
Yeah!
Okay, let's get started.
There we go.
I like how you guys are making imprints. This folder's gonna make an imprint.
Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Let's try this one right here, shall we?
I found this.
Ooh, look at that one.
Mr. Crosslin.
Yes. Push that off.
I found this.
Oh, the very same one.
Yeah.
Cool. Anybody want this one?
Right here.
Okay, we'll try it. Here comes the dinosaur. Ready? Nice. All right, make your imprints. Okay, so as soon as you get the water, start stirring. Start stirring. Yeah, it's dust. Wills needs water.
I need a little bit more.
Put it on. Yeah, yeah. Put it on. Start. Hey, put that on there. Okay, good idea. Stir that really good. You should be putting it on there by now. All of it.
Look, I take that. Yes.
There it is.
We're making a cake.
I'm going to get the rest on. Yeah, she was supposed to put this on
it. Put the rest on it. Yeah, but instead of smearing it like that, no, when I told you to shake it.
Thank you. Sorry.
All right, so we've waited some time, but not long, long. We just waited a little bit. And so this is a model of a fossil. So this is like the mud, and now we're gonna, I'm gonna do a few of these here, and I can kind of bend it, and would you, this is yours, right? Let's pull off, here's a piece, and look at that. You can see both of those. And go ahead and carefully lift that piece up. Carefully, slowly reveal. Turn it over.
Oh,
look at that. And look.
Dang.
First ever, a full triceratops or T-Rex.
T-Rex
head. And here is the mold. Turned out really cool. Who would like to see, well, you want to try yours?
Yeah.
Okay, help me, let's lift this up and push back the sides like this. Push them back. Push them back. Dun, dun, dun. Push them back. And now, you carefully reveal. Oh, turn it over.
Let's see.
Look at that. So here is the mold, and here is the cast. And this is a type of fossil. Great job. Hey, when we're done with this, I need to save this clay. So we want to get all the plaster out of it and put it back in the plastic bag for me, okay? Yeah. Who else wants to reveal one? You want to reveal yours? Okay, push down the sides. Push down the sides. Go ahead, help me. Push down the sides, and let's see if we can lift it up. Go ahead and lift it up. Let's see what we got there from this corner. It's okay if it breaks, because not all fossils perfect. Oh, look at that. And that, and there's another one.
That looks cool.
And you can glue these back together, take that piece off. Nice job. Here he comes. Push it down. Let's pull it up a little bit. Here, let's try on the sides. Okay, flip it over. Slowly.
Whoa.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Go ahead and separate so I can save the clay. Anybody else want to try this? Right, go ahead and see. Push it down. Move the other hand out of the way so we can see. Keep going. Well, as you can see, we've learned a lot about fossils. Remember, fossils are
things that are in clay.
Preserve evidence of ancient life. Nice. And we got one more we'll try. Go ahead. And I want to save the clay. A fossil is preserved evidence of ancient life. And life can be a plant or an animal. There we go. And the T-Rex head. Our ancient evidence of plastic dinosaurs. I'm not sure. Here we go. No, these are models, and you're going to make one. Let's see. How are you doing? Nice. Flip it over. What do we got? Nice.
That's time.
Okay. So what did you learn about fossils today? Anybody? What did you learn about fossils?
Fossils take many years.
Yeah. Long, long.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Hey, great job. Continue your studies. Next week, you're going to learn how fossils tell a story and what's in a fossil name. See you next time. Cool. Very cool.